That's good. The national championship game is underway in Boston. All these players hoping their championship dreams come true today. Last year they made it to the Frozen Four, lost in the semifinal. And here we go. The final college hockey game of the season is underway. Scoring first, so important for both of these teams. Now time for our Capital One Impact players. And these are four important ones, Colby Cohen.
Yeah, these guys can find different ways to score. Nathan Smith, the lone draft pick for the Minnesota State Mavericks. How about Carter Savoy, the overtime winner, hooking up with Bobby Brink. Guys, big-time players make big-time plays, and this is the biggest game any of these guys have played in to date. So somebody is going to be a hero.
Here comes McCade Webster, fourth-line center. Sister McKenna won a natty for Wisconsin. The Lady Badgers in 2021. First big save by Dryden McCade. Stuck out that left pass. Got a lot of experience. Number 18. He'll jump over the boards and change. Naprovnik. Here comes Mass, the defenseman. He'll fire. Saved by Chrona. Well out of his crease. First shot on goal.
Ooh. And again, the rebound into the corner. Not in front of the net. Into the corner.
Pavel. Shot saved by Chrona in the gut as Josh Grohl gets the second shot on goal for Minnesota State. Carroll's got speed. Trying to go around his net. There it is.
The right call.
It's been a Frozen Four with a lack of power plays, but we got one here in the first from these Hockey East officials.
Yeah, this is the right call to make. The tripping penalty where a player gets the stick stuck in on the feet. You see Benning takes Carroll down.
Minnesota State 22-1 since Christmas. Denver 19-4-1. Here they come in front. Sandlin backhand. Chrona strong on the puck and keeps it out.
Necessarily pull up and set up, and that's exactly what Sauter's looking to do here. He's looking to make a play at the net. Mayhew makes a good defensive play, but all of a sudden you put the stress on the goaltender, you create a 50-50 puck on the crease, and he fires it.
Well, they won the draw. This is the third straight time they've won the draw with the right-handed shot getting the shot, so that's going to come back to haunt.
Martin scores! Sam Martin, Colorado native, makes it 1-0 Minnesota State. It's his ninth of the year.
Yeah, faceoffs are just so important this time of year. Livingstone ends up with the puck. He creates a little bit of space by moving towards the middle, and then it's just simple. It's down to the half wall, it's towards the net, Barry, and then Morton's gonna slam it home.
That's exactly what we talked about. They did everything perfect, fundamental hockey, winning the draws, walking to the middle, throwing it back down low, Sandlin in front of the net, supplying the screen, have him tied up with one or two defensemen, moving it through the box one more time, and they get the shot. Just great, great hockey by a well-coached team.
Hit Sandlin, he should get an assist on that goal. Penalty, Minnesota State. Denver's power play will have a chance. Roughing's going to be the call on Nathan Smith, the dude who leads them in scoring and pins. Got Lutz behind him. Takes the body. Puck goes to Lutz in front. Can't quite connect with Morton. Andy Carroll behind the net. Lutz is open. Big save. Chrona. Here comes Sandlin with Furry.
Change.
Denver changing. Blast save by Chrona. Furry got a lot on that one. And now the Pios come the other way. Break. Has room now. Leaves it. Barron's shot over the net. Rebound off the post. Big chance down low for Cole Gutman to tie the game. Back out of midair. 4 seconds left. Smith will try to win this back to Lutz. He does. Lutz. Oh, he looked to pass it down to Carroll. Set play. Make that Hirose. Carroll can't whack it, and the first period comes to an end. Sam Morton, Colorado native, Lafayette, Colorado.
A lot about during the Olympics. He brought it back here. He talked to his guys, skate, get above the puck, and gap up continually.
Minnesota State 19-1 when leading after one. That was Morton's first goal since March the 5th. And how about that pass by Lucas Sauter?
I like Chrona. He's fired up. He He knows the other guy's getting all the ink.
Livingstone moves in front. Chrona trying to cover it up, and he does. There's Bobby Brink, the nation's leading scorer, number 24, trying to dig it out. Got Barrow in front. Gutman has it. Turns, Andy Carroll. One-timer lead right into the logo of Dryden McKay.
Leads their team in offense. How about he leads their team in penalty minutes? And that's a good example of some physical play. Obviously, that one, not a penalty, but this is a multi-dimensional player who does just about everything in all three zones.
Complete package. You're exactly right.
Grega. Wrist shot. Chrona will hang on. We'll get the whistle. And we'll take a break as the pushing and shoving and linesman hitting the deck. Denver will try to stay patient here. Still down just 1-0. Remember, they were down to Minnesota Duluth.
Yeah, too many men, guys. A linesman was all over. That was a bad change for Minnesota State. There were six guys out on the ice.
You ready? Nathan Smith will serve the penalty.
Yeah, big opportunity here, guys. And Benning will be the lone soldier defenseman on this second power play group that's going to start for the DU Pioneers. Good stick by Cellier up at the point to knock that pass out of the air. Turnover up at the blue line, knocks it out of the air. You can hear it hit the shaft of his stick. Some great work by our ESPN squad of production team there, and a save by Chrona. But you're right, Barry. He might have had help in Sauter if he would have maybe got his head up and went to the backhand. There might have been an open net for Sauter.
Yeah, everyone knew exactly what he was going to do. Me and Butchie up here knew exactly what he was going to do. Because
back the other way. Here comes Dubrovnik. Dubrovnik towards the net with Smith going right down the middle as he throws down Sean Barrows. Chasing it down. He has it. Here comes the pile. That little 3-on-2 late developing. Rizzo has Mazur and Wright. Rizzo, right! Oh, he had an open net! What a pass by Rizzo! His NCAA tournament magic continues. Number 13 has been outstanding. And the Pioneers now, late developing, 3-on-2. They got numbers. One-timer! Wide, whistled wide, hard slap shot by Wright. Comes all the way down the end. Here comes Sauter! Blocker side into the netting. Game starting to open up a little bit now. Both teams perhaps ready to start to pounce. Not a lot of offense so far. Chrona and McKay off the crossbar. Yo, ding dong. Pavel around the net in front. Turnaround shot saved by Chrona. It's loose. He doesn't know where it is, but it's whistled dead. On the ice, under 10. Minnesota State were able to exit. Play starting to heat up here in the second. Especially the Pioneers. They finally found some footing towards the end of the second period. But that man with that big leg save on Carter Mazur.
You need to make him feel that and feel uncomfortable if Denver's going to get one by him.
The Mavericks hope they're 20 minutes away from their first national championship in D1 school history. Denver gunning for their ninth, which would tie Michigan for the most all time. Go back and get it. Does. But watch out. Maybe late developing 2-on-1. Furry. Livingstone. Shot. Save. Chrona.
Remember that save, guys. If Denver's able to get back into this one, that's a big time save, as this one is going to go down and be an icing, which they don't. They're sending guys.
McNeely walks in. Bad angle shot is loose. Backhander. Two chances. Oh! And it just flutters wide. Might have caught a piece of the post. On the off wing. Turn. Throws it behind the net. Josh Grohl will chase it down. Grohl. Back to the point. One timer mass. Boy, he pounded that. Chrona save. Another save. Loose in front. Pavel throws it in front. Minnesota State starting to string together chances. But here come the Pios. Stapley. Devine. Looking to make a play. In front. Oh, Stapley can't get it. Benning fires. Score! Ryan Barrow ties the game. 1-1.
Well, it sort of looked like Minnesota, John, was sort of sitting on that lead, thinking that might be enough to win the period. But they just kept going. Denver kept battling, getting the puck deep. That's a great play right there, freezing up. Man goes to net, and there's the traffic in front. Loose puck in front, the rebound was just sitting there. Great job, just a great period.
And this play actually starts on a 3-on-2 for Denver that turned into a 3-on-5. So they're outnumbered offensively, but Benning, who came off the bench, heads right towards the offense, continues his momentum moving forward. And it's a simple play, guys. It's a shot towards the net and a hungry rebound for Ryan Barrow, one of the seniors for the DU Pioneers.
And yet it's Sandlin hard to the boards. Oh, that's a penalty. Power play, Denver. Morton sent Gutman flying in the air. And looking for the momentum, looking for the quick breakout.
Been in a big moment right here. Four forwards and Sean Barron's the defenseman on the power play. They get the face off. In front shot, save McKay. It's loose. And McKay covers up Carter Savoy, who leads them in game-winning goals.
Right. Rizzo! Oh, he tried to tuck it in and surprise McKay. Booyah, penalty over. One-timer, goal! Oh, baby! Denver takes the lead! Michael Benning! And that power play sticks in the air! To Pio Nation!
Great shift. Every battle was won. Puck movement was fantastic. They tried to go behind the net once on the goaltender, so he had to stay tight to the post. Just watch it, trying to jam it. Hunt the puck down, throw it out to the point. Can't shoot it, blocked. And then that was just a great one-timer up under the bar, Johnny. Wow.
Well, Barry, one of the biggest differences in this power play, Denver shooting to create chances. Not every shot needs to be under the crossbar. Minnesota State, they've done it all game. They've shot for rebounds. They've shot to create chances. Well, Denver takes a little page out of Minnesota's book. They get three or four rebounds. They create a scramble. And then all of a sudden, they set up the pretty play. And
down here, whether it's a TV timeout or...
See how they're shooting now? Just everything's going towards the net.
Score! No, it's waved off. It is waved off. Immediately waved off. Dryden McKay bumped off his position.
McKay, here's a good look at it.
Easy call.
Yeah, Bobby Brink runs into the goaltender, and this one's definitely going to continue to be no goal as the officials are going to go in. And
I didn't think he was cheering for me.
Minnesota State's been good on faceoffs. Denver can't afford to ice it, but steal. Carter King. King. Wrist shot saved by McKay as usual outside the blue paint. Shot off. Minnesota State would like a late game power play. Denver will try to avoid that. They're making it difficult now for the Mavericks to get up the ice. The tables have been turned, but McKay with the glove save as Denver tries to draw the penalty for their third national championship in the city of Boston. Mass, wrist shot, oh! Blocker saved by Chrona.
He's going through the middle right now.
Watch out, Mazur, 2-on-1. Mazur, Rizzo, Mazur, Rizzo, score! Massimo Rizzo has had an outstanding NCAA tournament. He takes the pass from Carter Mazur. Minnesota State is absolutely stunned.
Yeah, the collision at the blue line, Butchie, created a ton of mayhem out into the shallow part of the neutral zone. And you rarely see a team get a 2-on-1 from the red line down. And you see some of the reactions.
...20-year-old for Burnaby, British Columbia, Massimo Rizzo. His 12th goal of the year, and the 20-year-old. Now the Mavs need a miracle. Lutz, tipped, oh, just wide. Threatening now, Lutz, wrist shot, gloved by Chrona. stick stuck in the glass.
Oh,
another collision. This time Furry and the referee. Rizzo, he's feeling good. He fires to McKay. Rebound is loose. Still loose, but back comes Minnesota State. Back the other way. They need one. They need one soon. Fake shot. Goal! Furry couldn't get a handle on it. Minutes away from a national championship, but Minnesota State still has a chance. Hirose, shot, loose, all the chicken slide. Smith has it. Patient and waiting. Back to Napravnik. Denver's collapsing. Shot is just wide. It's going to come out of the zone. 2:40 left to a national championship for Denver. It would be their third in Boston. Steal, Stapley to ice it. Yes! So close, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen for Minnesota State. They can't believe it. A four-goal third period by the mighty Denver Pioneers. Four goals on their last eight shots against the Hobey Baker winner. That's Mazur. Here comes Mazur.
Scoring unassisted at 17:28.
Mazur has it back. Wright. Yes. Cameron Wright is going to end his college career as a national champion. From Bowling Green to Denver, he gets his 23rd of the year, and what a way to go out. Yeah, give that man a ring. That's going to do it. The countdown is on in Boston. Boston is their kind of town. For the third time, the Pios do it in Boston. National champions. Shake line now, and then of course we'll have Colby Cohen talk to a couple players and the coach David Carl. What a great moment for him. Again, would have been drafted as a young man with NHL dreams, went to the combine, realized he had a heart condition. It's Tommy Barrett of the NCAA. He has the trophy. Everyone came here to win. Youngest coach to win a national championship since 1963.
As a brother played in the NHL.
Matt, of course, a great college career. Good NHL player as well. Tears of joy there. And Mike Hastings got his team one step farther this year. Perhaps it'll take another year to fulfill the ultimate dream next year in Tampa Bay. But for Sean Behrens and his Denver Pioneer team.
Both these coaches were unbelievable. Their teams are so disciplined, nothing stupid.
Cameron Wright trying to lead his team to the center ice dot to shake hands. Boy, Mike Hastings is going to be thinking about this all summer long. What happened?
All summer long, forever.
What happened in the third period? And no one can figure it out. It's a chin grabber. It's a head scratcher.
Congratulations to
it's hard to figure out what happened, but Denver figured it out, and Bobby Brink and the Pioneers were able to finally break through. And then once they break through, Barry, it was a waterfall.
One period, you get five shots.